Right, so we've managed to get into the most important corridor in all of British television history. It's the Red Dwarf corridor here at Shepperton. Look at this, it's the makeup room. Then further down here, we've got the dressing rooms. Here is Chris Barry's one. He's behind that door right now. Shall I knock? Shall I just knock? I better knock. And further down here, we have Danny John Jules's one. I expect he's got some of his crazy outfits as Cat in there. And in here is Craig Charles's dressing room. I'm about to go in. He's just finishing up a cup of tea, and then I'm going to go and talk to him. Let's see what he has to say. Right, so we're in Craig Charles's dressing room. I can't quite believe this is happening, this whole Red Dwarf thing still. Can you believe it's happening?
Yeah, look, it says so on the door, Craig Charles, Red Dwarf. it's been a long time, 10 years. And, you know, for a good few years, we were trying to put the film together, and, you know, we'd get the fund, and then it collapsed, and we'd get the fund, and then it collapsed, and then... I suppose I'd put it in a box and put it away, put it down to, you know, a very sort of happy stage in my life and, you know, a very successful career move, as it were, and got on about my business, you know. And I was quite reluctant, really, to come back and do it again after so long because, you know, times move on, you know, things change, fashions change, you know, and, you know, I've got a whole other life now, and which I'm quite happy with. And then, but then Doug sent me the script. And once I read the script, I just thought, well, you know, I've got to have a bit of this. It's just a typical Red Dwarf mind melter, and it's hilarious. And I just thought, oh, I want to be part of it, I want to be part of it. My big problem was with Coronation Street released me for it, and they've been fantastic to me. They said, yeah, okay, great, because I think they're all fans as well, you know. And certainly, like, a lot of the cast on Corrie are like, I grew up with it, you know, especially the young ones. I mean, Ryan Thomas, who plays Jason, he looks a bit like me when I was younger. His nickname at school was Lister, you know, because he looked like me. So everyone was really excited, and they let me go. And the script's brilliant, and came down here and forgot how difficult it was. It's really tough work, you know. It's really physical, demanding, concentration-sapping show, you know. A lot of it's on green screen stuff, because, you know, times have changed, and computer graphics are such now that you can make it look fantastic for half the money that you used to. So we've got this top guy in from New Zealand who's worked on all the Lord of the Rings things and all that, and he's just like a diva when it comes to computer graphics. So we, fingers crossed, it should look fantastic, but we're all still pretty crap. But it looked good.
How much fun has it been getting back together with all the guys? Because I know you've stayed in contact, but I mean, yeah. Working with them, you know, on Red Dwarf again.
We've been in contact all the time, you know. We've released DVDs each year and that kind of stuff, and that's sort of kind of kept Red Dwarf in the public eye. But it was just when we got back into the costumes was the weirdest one, you know, because like you wonder if you know who Dave Lister is anymore, you know, and do you do Dave Lister at like 10 years older, or do you keep him the way you left him in 98? And so you got all of that, but you put the boots on, and you put the leather pants on, and you put the jacket on, and the leather glove, and you start walking different, and all of a sudden I'm Dave Lister again. It's weird, you know. You get the dreadlocks in, you're like, whoa. This is the outfit from 92.
Oh, wow.
This still fits, yeah, and the leather jacket, come with me. And that's the original leather jacket from Series 3, the one with Wilma Flintstone on the back riding the rocket, and that still fits. So, all in all, it's been a shot in the arm for the old ego, actually, you know, because if we'd done this, say, last year, sort of early last year, I was really chubby. And I wouldn't have been able to get anywhere near that costume.
I was going to say, if those trousers are from 92, 17 years later, that's impressive for anyone. That's good work.
Either I was just really fat in 92, I don't know. But yeah, it's everything fits. Chris is in fantastic shape. He's gone a bit grey, but, you know, so what? Danny's gone grey. It doesn't matter, though. He wears a wig. And Robert has really let himself go, but he's got a mask on. So do you know what I mean?
We don't know that much about the plot. It's all been kept very secret, but obviously you do. I mean, does it make... I mean, I know you can't really tell us, but will there be more Red Dwarf after this, and does this plot lead into, you know, a new way forward?
I can't really say. I don't know. I mean, and that's the truth, you know. Let's see how the audience react, you know. I mean, see what the appetite is like for more Red Dwarf, and if the appetite's there, then, you know, and Doug wants to write it and the lads want to do it, then I don't know how it go ahead. I might have a problem with Coronation Street. They've been really kind letting me do this, you know, and it's one of those shows that I certainly don't want to leave, because I just love doing it, you know. But I'm sure we could work something out, because it's really hard work, but at the end of the day, you get a real satisfied feeling when you're at home or sitting in your hotel room and you've finished it, that you know you're doing something good, you know. And if we get a kick in, it's only out of spite, really, because it's good. What we're doing is good. And not me. I'm not talking about me. I'm talking about them, do you know what I mean? And they just let me hang out with them. Do you know what I mean? And wear leather and look cool.
Brilliant. Craig Charles, thank you very much for talking to us.
Oh, cheers.